now. I think that my battery will be running out soon. It'll start flashing. But anyway, so I was asked this lovely question about one of the spiritual teachers of enlightenment, Ramana Maharishi, teacher of enlightenment, and he had sarcoma. How can a teacher of enlightenment have cancer? And so these are my views. I remember Hawkins saying something really, really lovely about it. And now, if you go to the observer of the body, and you are the observer of the body, you're not your body. So whatever happens to the body is not really relevant. You know, if it drops down, you're not that. You have clear seeing that the body is not you, the thoughts are not you, and the world is an illusion. So if the body topples over, it isn't you anyway. So just like if I'm observing a mug and the mug falls over, so the mug's fallen over. It's been observed that it's fallen over. Now, I remember Hawkins sort of saying, when he was on his spiritual journey, that he became attracted to A Course in Miracles. And as I understand, anyway, he was having a class of A Course in Miracles students, and they were doing A Course in Miracles. And at about lesson 76, he would usually do this thing with all of the students with muscle testing, kinesiology, and check with artificial sweetener and organic or non-organic foods. Like, you know, this artificial sweetener makes your arms go weak. Look at the fluorescent light, your arm goes weak. Then hold an organic apple, your arm stays strong. Hold an apple with pesticides, your arm goes weak. He was doing that, and then suddenly one day he just wanted to do the usual test to show everyone how external stimuli, and everyone was staying strong, saying, look at the fluorescent lights, and they were staying strong. And then they're putting apples with pesticide and they're staying strong. And then it was realized that actually by doing A Course in Miracles, the students were becoming immune to negative stimuli. They were no longer going weak. They could eat, you know, they could hold artificial sweetener, apples with pesticide, and they still wouldn't go as they were doing. They were letting go of their beliefs that anything outside of themselves can have a negative impact. Nothing in the world has any power. There isn't anything, it's just these are just beliefs that enslave all of the collective beliefs we're enslaved by. So, wow, that's incredible. And then it's kind of obvious, he didn't say this, but you know, with lesson 14 of A Course in Miracles, God did not create cancer, so it's not real. And it just goes to say this is part of the collective nightmare that we believe. So it's not real. You just cancel your belief, and no such thing as cancer exists. So you let it go and it doesn't exist. And so then it was kind of obvious, because Hawkins had so many illnesses, it was kind of obvious what should be done in terms of cancelling his beliefs, so God did not create them. So it intuitively came to him to start working on them. You know, God did not create gout, so it's not real. God did not create migraines, so they're not real. And all these miracles started happening. He let go of 23 illnesses, many of them life-threatening. So there was this thing in his journey, even though he became an enlightened teacher, if an enlightened teacher cancels this stuff. But eventually, what happened was, if you do that, anyway, eventually he lost interest in doing the work. It's like it doesn't really matter what happens to the body. And as I understand it, his daughter, so he's letting the body go. He's not interested in the body. So the body was starting to get ill. And his daughter came up to him and was like upset that the body looked like it was going to die or something. So she was so upset, so the consciousness decided to cancel the stuff again. And so he went on for another, you know, for some more years teaching. So it's like, it becomes more like an option, whether you know, at a certain point you don't care what happens to the body. Okay. It was just the case that his daughter didn't like to see the body topping off, so he just so the cancelling carried on and the body stayed, and then eventually, so it becomes a bit like that. So in terms of whether a spiritual teacher, you know, wants to cancel things or let things go, whether they care or not, is probably a little bit different in different spiritual teachers. I mean, once you transcend the body, you know, there's a kind of, okay, generally as you do spiritual work, things get better. But, you know, karma, you know, Hawkins refers it to a karmic wind-up toy. I mean, some of these karmas are deep-rooted. You know, even as you do lots of spiritual work, something's going to take the body out eventually. If you put spiritual work, like if suddenly you're in the observer and there's suddenly cancer and you go, God does not create cancer, so it's not real. God did not create cancer, so it's not real. In a high vibration, that will tend to clear it. Not guaranteed, it will tend to clear it. But whether the consciousness wants to do that or not, it just depends on the thing. So that's the way I would answer it. For some they may cancel it, or they may let it go, or it may get resolved in the spiritual work, or they may at least let it be there. Some of them may want, you know, but be like Hawkins would make jokes, like, we need an excuse to let go of the body. You know, so it's like, it's kind of a funny thing. Great, you know, I get to leave now, you know, get cancer and take the body out, and there's no, you know, it's like, that's a great reason to, like, vacate this place to the next place, you know. So it's not like, we look at it, oh my God, he's got cancer, and it's like, conscious going, this is great, it's going to fall over, and, you know, I'm going to be free, you know. So to us, it might look like something, and to the enlightened teacher, it might look like something totally different.
Mm.